Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of the YouTube world. Guess what? I am back with more of Horizon Zero Dawn. And my God, this is a phenomenal game. It's so, so good. The story is getting so great, and I can't wait to see more of it. Damn. Man, this is so exciting, guys. I am so happy to be back with more Horizon Zero Dawn. This is where we left off last time. The story is getting so juicy, and oh my god, I love it. The last video, man, was, oh my god, was mind-blowing to me. Learning about everything down here and what's going on is insane. So I can't wait to see more going to Ted Farrell's office. So let's do it. The first ever trillionaire. Oh, that's so sick, dude. Welcome back, guys. Welcome back. I hope you enjoy this video, because I know I am. I'm fucking loving this game. Loving it. Cannot get enough of it. We got something right here. Yes.
Now, I know this must seem like a bizarre change in direction. I mean, we're Pharaoh Automated Solutions, right? Number one robotics firm in the world. Why would we clear our production slate to fabricate human-operated vehicles and weapon systems, the relics of the past? All I can say at this juncture is, trust me, we will be exploiting a massive growth opportunity by retooling and reallocating capacity according to my plan. So I will need revised projections of mass fabrication velocity across every pipeline within 36 hours.
So they were making machines, then they stopped to make other kinds of weapons? Why?
Interesting. Guess it's our turn to find out. Oh my god, I love finding those data like that. Those like video, like what do you call them? Audio logs. Yeah, I love finding those because it gives like great insight what's going on. I just came from here, right? Yeah. Okay, let's go back. I just want to make sure. I really don't want to miss anything at all. Definitely not in here. Like, I'm trying to figure out, like, this was kind of like a, probably their, like, main corporation, like, their business, like, this, like, tall-ass building, and basically where they ran the operations. Like, this is their main place. Huh. Interesting. We look around, 360. Oh, what? Do I go through here though? Like, I hate when they give me two spots to go through because I don't know which one to go. Well, the main. Hold on. Oh, we got something.
Another cave-in. But I could get through.
Complaint. Okay. Hey, reception, if that's your real... Want to know who scheduled Endo Melee right next to the fresh grounds? That would be me, Senior VP of Sales. Want to know why? After that little hair pulling incident, both sides increased their bids by 40%. I'll explain. Because you're a repetitionist level brain probably requires it. Those two sides are fighting. And what do we sell? That's right, combat machines. We want them to hate each other. So they will try to fight each other with what? That's right again, combat machines. Which they would pay us a lot of money for. So I suggest you go back to serving coffee with a blank smile and let me do much more complicated job. Thank you. Thanks a bunch, Mr. Fredkin, to you. Damn, he went off. He went fucking off, bro. Is that another cave in? Nope, don't do it. I want to go back because I want to see what's down there. I don't know which way is the right way, but I feel like that's the right way, so I want to go this way. To see what's down on this side. Yep, I found something. I knew it.
Should have brought a cart.
Well, I found a crate. I thought maybe there might be something else down here. It's gotta be, right? There's gotta be, right? Anything? For real, nothing? I want more audio logs. Okay. Basically, did went down here for nothing, but I wanted to make sure. I really did. I don't want to miss anything, like I said. Let's keep going. Alright, this way, yeah. Alright. Oh, fuck! Shit! That scared the fuck out of me, dude. What the shit was that? Wasn't cool. Do me like that. I guess we're supposed to fall. I didn't fall, but. There's a ladder right here. But what do we got? Shit. Oh, wait. This is back where we... What'd you say I can use as a what to get back up? I already seen that. Where the fuck? Oh, here we go, alright. Alright, here we go. I don't know where to go from here. There we go. Supply crate. Can you get through here now? When they get on that other side. Okay. Oh. Oh, here we go. Figured it out.
Made it.
This is a big ass place, man. Yo, you want me to go that way? Nah, I gotta have it. I gotta explore more. Look at this. Yep. High priority alert. Priority. Automated log note. All non-essential systems have entered hibernation. High priority alert. Automated log note. Log note. Full lockdown has been initiated. Due to increasing frequency of violent protests targeting the campus security at FAS, employees can no longer be guaranteed. Therefore, we have taken the difficult decision to shutter this facility indefinitely. Staff will be briefed on a block-by-block basis regarding proper procedure for achieving and or slash disposal of project-related data and materials. I think for archiving. Yeah, for archiving. Yeah. Archiving and disposal. Okay. HiSec and Crisis Team will then conduct exit review before all areas are locked down. Priority messaging to all staff and ENF blocks. Treat the current lockdown situation as acceptable. Do not attempt to release the hatches or otherwise exit the buildings. A reminder that while HiSec personnel remain committed to employee safety during the current unfortunate events, personal firearms must be relinquished. That's not how you say that. Relinquished, yeah. When president for idea, because I was like, why can't I say that? I know the word. I know how to say it. Like, why is it leaving me? Additional public SS roads. I guess because it's my first time, like, actually looking at the word. I don't know. Additional public SS roads en route to the campus have not been closed to relieve waiting time at the outer security corridors. HiSec reminds all staff that campus remains off limits to the public following recent campus. Okay. Okay. Analyze every single act, terrorism directed at the revolves. Big brother to a queen staff traveling from all sites. Sign up is required and strongly encouraged. 48 more entries in high. Okay. Damn. That was a mouthful. But I enjoyed all of that.
So people were angry at Faro. At the corporation.
Yep.
They blamed this place for something. Something bad.
Damn, I love it. Oh, what we got? What do we got? Yes. Give me more. Paula Vassera. Paula, recent events have sharpened my perspective, and I think I, NFAS in general, have been neglecting the spiritual side of things, not under any specific religious framework, of course, but in more general sense, as is not given enough thought to our shared values, hopes, and aspirations for the afterlife. I'd like you to reach out to religious leaders of every stripe with the intention of scheduling a conference soon. Very soon, I have more thoughts about the agenda later, but for now, let's put out some fillers and see if we can lock something in. Make it a big tent, no cooks, but anyone with a credible audience, let's go deluxe. Make it clear, we'll spare no expense. Thanks, Ted. Okay. Alright then. I get to have that business meetings, okay. Maybe I check this place out. Whoa! Are you kidding me? What is this?
The ACA-3 Scarab combines conventional and information warfare capabilities in one package. Designed for high-speed, all-terrain reconnaissance, it boasts the world's highest survivability rating of any Scout-class autonomous agent. Maybe it's the Scarab's emergency biomass conversion systems that ensure it always makes it back to base, even if fuel supply lines have been interdicted. Or maybe it's the Scarab's ability to slave enemy robots to its own network. Now that's force multiplication. Add a prehensile manipulator arm that can handle a host of functions, from 360-degree less lethal riot management.
Huh. Is that the same thing?
The FSP-5 Kopesh provides a one-size-fits-all solution to main battle force capability. Metamaterial construction delivers unmatched.
Oh, if I go away from it, it'll stop. Okay. I kind of get the gist. I'm gonna see what this one says.
The BOR-7 Horus. Imagine your complete engagement ecosystem comprehensively managed by a high-speed learning machine network. Whether your need is to replace battlefield losses or intensify force projection, the Horus's onboard manufacturing capabilities mean you'll never get stuck waiting for the next arms delivered. Simply redefine your force parameters, and the Horus will fabricate additional units to fill the ranks for an affordable per-unit licensing fee. Meanwhile, the biomass conversion systems of other chariot line models allow them to keep the Horus fueled, repaired, and ready, extending its operational tolerances beyond that of...
Alright, let's keep going. Kinda messed it up because I didn't know I can walk through it and mess it up, but anyways.
Looks like the way up.
Here's about the...
What's left of it.
Yeah, what's left of it? Yeah, he was about to finish up anyway. But I kind of understand what he was talking about, so I don't really need to hear everything. Let's keep going.
Gonna be a long way up. Frozen metal most of the way. Not making this easy, Dr. Sobek.
No, she is not. I love when he's like, Elizabeth Sobek. Elizabeth, what kind of name is that? I love that shit.
If kids can find a way to hang on up here, guess I can too.
Let's do it. This is so cool, dude. Guess we go this way.
That began when they engaged in unauthorized offensive operations against robots and human personnel of the Hearts Timor Energy Combine. Now I wish that I could relate that the crisis has been exaggerated, but it's not. The peacekeepers have not responded to stand down codes, and by all signs, they appear to be replicating at a precipitous rate. Now, what I can promise you, can absolutely assure you, is that I am already devoting every possible resource towards reaching a speedy conclusion to this issue. So when you hear the bad talk about us against this company in the days, maybe weeks to come, just bear in mind that we will get past this. And the day's coming when none of this will matter.
Peacekeepers. That's what they called their machines. They were built for war, not peace.
Exactly. Let's keep going. Dude, we're way up here. Yes, this one is Snow Lodge, like I said earlier. It's basically their corporation, their business.
Snow. It's not getting any warmer out here.
We were just in the desert. Which makes this funny.
I'd have to ditch something.
Just go down here and get this. Supply crit. Just want to make sure it wasn't like a data thing. Wait, what was that behind it? Never mind. Here we go. All hands on deck. Even Jenna, right? Yeah. Ever hear that Melville Island Fruit Association? Neither had I. I mean, you could say it either way, I guess. Until they feel suspicious against us this morning. Apparently, there is a little island paradise off the coast of Australia, population 2,700 of all whom hate us. Now that Stray Hearts Tibor unit is chowing down on their largest mango accord that breaks the official count of hard timber related lawsuits to 127, most of them from private companies, but also a bunch of from individuals, nation states, and NGOs. And that's not even counting the mother of all liability claims from Hearts itself. Call every external firm we ever used and call their competitors. We're going to need every corporate defense lawyer we can find who's still half sober and on the bar. Huh. Interesting. Leap! Oh fuck, I thought I didn't make that. I rise up. Like, how far can I go up here? Is there a way I can go anywhere else? No. Okay. Just making sure. Because you can go up pretty high on that thing.
Can't carry more.
Damn, I can't get nothing from that one. What kind of shit is this? Dude, I'm getting way up here. Oh, here we go. I take some shards. Dude, this place was massive. I like how there's a fucking supply crate. Nobody's been here for fucking over hundreds of years. And there's a supply crate of fatty meat. I just think that's so funny. So what do I do? Oh, I see. Do we have to drop or do I just jump? I got it. Thank you.
No space.
Ooh, what the fuck? That was so close. I'm glad that was there. Your boy is grateful for that. So grateful. Okay. Let's keep going up. Nope, not that way. There we go. What's that say? Bandit incident? From Stacy Anders to Robert. Okay, Bob. Another problem to add to our big steaming pile. Apparently, a fisherman and the bandits catch a video of a horse timber or horse until refueling via biomatter conversion along with shoreline or polo weather. Don't know what that means. On a power endangered dolphins, no less, quite possibly the last of their kind. Not to get graphic, but it looks like what happens inside a blender, as if the robot was whipping up a big pink swirl milkshake of dolphin chum. Our suppression team has scrubbed it from 43 networks, but it's still propagating, so it's only a matter of time before it goes viral. A prepared statement feels grossly insufficient. Any suggestions? This one's a real stinker. Damn. Not looking good. Not sounding good either.
A way up. All it takes is a few good handholds.
I like how she addresses that.
All right. Made it. Wonder what we'll find.
We better find something. I climbed all the way up here. There better be something up on this bitch. Search. Oh, this is his office? Damn, his office is fucking high.
All data has been erased from this device. Do you wish to deploy alpha privileges to recover purge data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
A file has been recovered.
Scan the data point. Watch.
Good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed. I assume your data confirms this.
All right, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So spit it out.
There's a glitch in the chariot line.
You're killing robots?
Peacekeepers, yes. Those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data, then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Faro brought Elizabeth Sobek here, but they hated each other.
Another file has been recovered.
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
that consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
What?
The Pharaoh robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
A final
cell
has been recovered.
Project Zero Dawn. Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I am speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
What made her solution so terrible? What did she do to stop the robots?
Executive access detected.
What the fuck? Oh my god. This is fucking crazy, bro. Damn, that's so sick. I was getting like super teary out of this listening to him. Like, I didn't want to say anything. I was so like drawn in what they were saying. I was like, what? Dude, this is so good. Oh my god.
I can't spare the wait.
Wow, look how high I am, guys. I'm on top of this motherfucker. The very top. That's insane though, man. Like, I can't, I'm speechless talking about the story, because I'm like, this is so fucking cool. Oh, damn, dude. I love it, dude. I fucking love it. Fucking trillionaire makes these killer robots, calls them peacekeepers, got out of control. He made a replica. That's how they fucking like keep coming, because he made that self replication of them so they can fucking replicate. And like, he's, and it, I don't know what Zero Dawn is. I don't know how she like stopped the robots. Like, how is like, you know, civilization still here? I can't wait to figure that out. Like, wow, fucking wow. Oh shit, dude. This game just went from like 10 to fucking 100 to me. It was fucking great. Now it's phenomenal. Now it's just like, what? hands down, one of the best stories so far. Hands down, one of the best open worlds so far. One of the best, like, RPGs. Like, damn, this is a. Like, I'm gonna go out on a limb right now. I mean, Mass Effect 2 story was pretty good, but Witcher 3 is kind of alright. I mean, I didn't really like Witcher 3 story because it's so fucking long, but Fallout 3, eh. Skyrim, eh. I'm just saying, like, all, like, RPG-wise, like, I feel like this one, so far, I'm not going to go, like, say it is yet because I haven't beaten it, but so far, the best story, like, most interesting, at the very least, this is, like, really cool. Like, I'm super into stuff like this, like, into robots and, like, kind of, like, dinosaur, apocalyptic stuff, like, apocalypse and, like, fucking how, like, civilization falls. I'm, like, super into that, and this is, like, so, like, I don't know, like, makes me so happy to see, because I'm, like, playing a game like this, never play one, I think, like, super like this ever. So, like, I don't know, I'm, like, speaking, like, crazy, and talking both sides of my mouth, because I'm, like, so, like, don't know really what to say, because it's, like, I need to, like, process it, you know, because it's so fucking, like, it hits you, like, oh, fuck, this is sick. But anyways, that's my take on it so far, and I can't wait to see more.
This doesn't add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the Old Ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that feral robots destroyed their civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name.
He's got a point. Sylens,
that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? Something less trivial.
If you're so smart, you don't understand. I see your point. Yeah, I see his point, definitely. But that's what I'm gonna go with. But yeah, I'm like, if I was sort of like, I'm gonna ask so many questions. Like, what happened here? Like, what the fuck? Like, this happened? And like, so what? So this makes that happen? Like, what's Zero Dawn? When you figure that out? Like, I'm like, I'll be going all crazy. Like, your name? Yes, yeah, she's talking about. Where she couldn't be my mother and all that. Like, did you just not see what I just seen? Like, if I was in her shoes, I would went like. I've been asking so many damn questions. But anyways.
All right, Sylens. You've made your point. I came to these ruins hoping to learn more about this Elizabeth Sobek. And I have, but I still don't understand my connection to her. Or why the Eclipse is trying to kill me. Or who Hades is. No answers, just one question after another.
Exactly. Which is why it's time to expand your frame of inquiry. Only then will you see just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobek.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you. We've only just now learned that feral robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One's civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
I have questions. I do have a lot more questions.
Not so fast, Sylens. You've got some explaining to do.
I've told you quite enough. If you still got questions, be quick about it and stop wasting my time.
He said, if you got questions, be quick about it. Look at all these questions I could ask. Your intentions.
Who are you, Sylens? And what are your intentions?
You really need to make this personal? I'm a lone wanderer who left his tribe behind a long time ago. An explorer of forbidden places, a searcher of lost knowledge. Exactly as I said.
Why do you know so much about the eclipse?
I happen to know a lot about a lot of things. If what you're really asking is whether I work for the eclipse or anyone else, I don't. I am nothing if not independent. Now that's enough talking. Be on your way.
Oh no. I'm just getting started. You've been getting a free ride on my focus, risking nothing while I risk everything. All I have to do is take this thing off my head, and you'll be blind, deaf, and dumb. So quit complaining and answer my questions.
Very well. Proceed.
Damn, like, she knows how to, like, fucking communicate, damn, what's the word? Debate? Anyways.
You said you've known for some time that Faro war machines destroyed the civilization of the old ones.
The evidence pointed that way. But until now, I never knew the full scope of their danger. That they could process organic matter into fuel, or that the Horus class could manufacture more robots. Like a cauldron on legs.
But the robots we've seen so far, the corruptors and deathbringers, they don't do those things.
Not yet, anyway. So far, we haven't encountered any that are undamaged. At full power, who knows what they're capable of?
You've been using my focus to spy on me. How's that possible?
Every focus emits a signal, a voice, that only other focuses can hear. I know how to string those voices together, how to make them talk to each other, to communicate, even over vast distances.
How do you learn to do that?
Years of study and experimentation. In principle, it's not so different from how you override machines. I override focuses.
And you can spy through other eclipses' focuses, too.
Usually. All I'll say is that overriding the connections is complicated.
Okay.
So far as I can tell, the Eclipse are just following orders. It's Hades who wants me dead. Who is he?
I don't know. The Eclipse describe him as a buried shadow, some kind of devil.
That thing that spoke to me outside, that made that focus explode. That was Hades. It didn't seem like a person or a machine. More like a phantom. With a terrible voice.
All that's certain is that he wants you dead.
Because of my connection to Elizabeth. Has to be.
Hades is using the Eclipse to resurrect Pharaoh robots.
But if Elizabeth found a way to stop them centuries ago, if she made special weapons, maybe Hades is worried I'll do the same thing.
In some of the ancient data I've recovered, there are hints of so-called super weapons being developed. Maybe to stop the robots, the civilization of the old ones had to destroy itself.
Interesting. I kind of just noticed her name is Elizabeth, not Elizabeth. I was like, that's, why not add the H?
Is there any chance that Elizabeth Sobek could still be alive somehow?
It's highly unlikely, but not impossible. Some of the ancient data I've recovered includes mentions of life extension techniques. Pharmaceuticals, mostly, an ancient word for medicine. But some were still trying to perfect ways of freezing and unfreezing people.
Freezing and unfreezing people?
Cryogenics, they called it. But there were problems with it. Given Elizabeth's technological acumen, I can't definitively rule out that she found a way to make herself immortal. But this is speculation. Wasting time.
Damn, that's interesting. She could be alive, because, you know, I mean, kind of like Fallout in a way, because, you know, you get in those little containers and you can, like, and, you know, basically, you're asleep for so many years, and then you finally get let out, and you haven't aged at all and all that. You know what I'm talking about. So it's possible she could be still, like, you know, frozen and haven't, like, came out of her little thing yet. So, could be a possibility.
Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asuram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait.
I can't wait either.
You meet in person, and your manners had better be improved.
Dude, that was so good.
Getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least.
That great for
Robot Command next. To learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.
Learn the ancient path. Fuck, that's crazy. Damn, we went over 40 minutes again, guys. I mean, the story's getting so good. I want you guys to see everything, and this is the main mission. I wanted to, like, talk to him and learn more about him. I wanted to show you guys everything, what I think about what's going on. So I'm about to end the video right here, right now. I don't want to make it super, super long. I know the last one was like 45 minutes, so this is getting up there. I'm sorry about these long videos. I really hope you enjoy them, though. I try my best to keep them short, but really I can't, because there's so much stuff you need to see and I need to see, so it's a process. I'm trying my best, guys. I try to make them shorter. Probably the next video might be shorter. We'll see how it goes. The Grave Horde. I wonder if I want to go to the Grave Horde next. I really want to, because this story is getting so good. But the other story is good too, you know, with Aaron and stuff. So, like, I'm really loving these two, like, main stories that's going on right now. But all that being said, guys, I'm leaving you. I am going to go, because it's getting, it's about that time. We all know it's about that time. So anyways, with all that being said, stay different from everybody else. You're witnessing greatness. I am out of here. I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.